All the very latest where you are now. It's the ITV News.
Tonight, a new Nightingale surge hub will be built to care for patients. It comes as COVID hospital admissions in the capital pass 450 a day. Also on the programme, one woman's fight to end the stigma around cancer in the black community. And a year in showbiz, we take you through the glitz and the glam of 2021. Good evening. A coronavirus surge hub will be set up in the capital in preparation for a potential wave of Omicron admissions. St George's Hospital in Tooting will be able to treat up to 100 patients who are not well enough to go home. It comes as COVID cases in London soared to another pandemic high today. The latest figures from NHS England show London has the highest number of beds occupied by COVID patients in the UK. 456 patients were admitted to hospital on the 28th of December. That is the highest number of COVID patients in hospital since the end of January this year. With just one day to go before Londoners celebrate New Year and tests still in short supply, scientists and hospitality staff alike are concerned about the virus spreading further. Hannah King's reports.
COVID rates in London are continuing to rise. And although the Omicron variant appears to be less severe, the sheer number of infections means hospital admissions are also increasing. This week, the number of COVID patients being admitted to the capital's hospitals each day passed 450, the highest it's been in 10 months. Some experts are worried.
It concerns me enormously. So again, you know, I think many people are becoming very blasé about this as the new normal. But believe me, if you go into those hospitals, if you have to work in those hospitals, it isn't normal. It doesn't feel normal at all. And it's not sustainable as a way for the NHS to function.
It's been announced today that 8 new surge hubs will be opened at hospitals in England to provide extra beds for COVID patients if they are needed. London's hub will be at St George's Hospital in Tooting. The surge hub here at St George's will have capacity for around 100 patients from hospitals across London where normal wards have become full. It will be for those who are on the road to recovery and need minimal support from medical staff, but who aren't quite ready to be discharged. Like the Nightingale hospitals that opened at the beginning of the pandemic, it's hoped these hubs will never be needed, but the NHS and government say it's important to have them ready just in case. With New Year's Eve just one day away, there are some fears about the impact that people getting together to celebrate could have on infections. The Prime Minister yesterday told people to enjoy New Year, but to take a COVID test before meeting others. The problem is that those tests are still in short supply. Jeremy Joseph owns GAY and Heaven nightclubs. He's happy to be opening tomorrow, but is aware that the test shortage could cause problems.
It's an absolute nightmare. What happens is the government brings in these laws, and they say, this is what you have to do to stay open. We have to put it into place, and we are expected to do that with no support, no help. It's just on our own. And then when people don't have their COVID passports on them, or they haven't taken their lateral flow test and they can't show the negative result, it's the security or the staff on the door of the venue who are taking the abuse from customers.
Having missed out on celebrating last year, many Londoners will be making the most of tomorrow. But as hospitals prepare for more COVID admissions, there are some concerns about what the new year may bring. Hannah Kings, ITV News.
Next tonight, New Year, say mild disruption on the trains. Earlier today, Southern Rail announced that no trains will run to and from London Victoria for the next 2 weeks. Nick Thatcher is here with me now. Nick, what more can you tell us?
Well, if you're one of those people dreading the return to work next Tuesday, this will not be welcome news. Southern announcing today that none of its services will run into or out of London Victoria, including the Gatwick Express, until next Monday, the following Monday, January the 10th. Because of what the company calls coronavirus isolation and sickness. So that's an additional week on top of the service disruption this week, which has seen no Southern services at Victoria Station because of planned signalling work. Now, I'm told tonight that new timetables will go online for this next week. It will be worth checking because some of those services will be diverted into London Bridge. But in fairness, Duncan, all the rail companies experiencing similar problems. Southwestern Railway saying tonight that they have staff shortages and that will mean short-term cancellations to their timetable as well. So the advice, as always, check before you travel. But if you're one of the thousands returning to work next Tuesday, it will be anything but business as usual.
Nick, thank you. A terrorist who plotted alongside Fishmongers Hall attacker Usman Khan is among dozens of offenders being considered for release from prison. The parole board is currently reviewing 92 cases referred by the Justice Secretary after the government changed the law to stop terrorists being automatically freed. One of those under review is Nazam Hussein, who plotted alongside London Bridge terrorist Usman Khan. His bid for freedom could be determined as early as next February. Police investigating an assault outside a Hackney bar have released CCTV of a man they want to speak to. Two men in their 20s got into a fight with another man after leaving a bar on Curtin Road in Shoreditch shortly after 11 p.m. on the 11th of July. One suffered a fractured skull and the other was left with a leg injury. Both have since been discharged but continue to recover from their injuries. Now, when Lucy LePay from Enfield found a lump on her breast, the thought of cancer never crossed her mind. But at 26 years old, she was diagnosed with breast cancer. Since then, she's had chemotherapy, radiotherapy and surgery, but is now cancer-free, having caught it early. She now wants more black women to be aware of the importance of an early diagnosis and to check themselves regularly for lumps. Here's Lucy's story.
My name's Lucy LePay. I was diagnosed with breast cancer in January 2019. I've since had chemotherapy, radiotherapy, surgery, hormone therapy, any kind of therapy you can think of, you name it, and I've probably had it. I quite literally was in my bed sleeping. I turned over and I cupped my left breast. And as I did so, I put my thumb directly onto a very tiny little lump. It was so weird to kind of hear the words that I had breast cancer. I didn't ever think that it would happen to me. It was never something that was in the back of my mind. I think one of the hardest things was thinking about how the whole experience was going to affect my son. I wasn't really thinking about me. I was thinking about my son. I was thinking about my mum. I was just kind of walking around like with this new knowledge that I have breast cancer, but no one else could see. No one else knew. It was kind of like my own little secret. I had my eggs harvested just to kind of protect myself because the chemo is so violent on the body. I would go to the hospital and there'd be all these like couples preparing to have a baby, and they were so happy and so excited. I was there because I was protecting myself against the worst case scenario that I may not be able to have children. When I hear the statistic that black women are less likely to get breast cancer, but twice as likely to get a late diagnosis and then, you know, sometimes even die from it. It just saddens me so much. Yes, I've had a rough journey. It's not been easy, but because I found my cancer early, I'm still here. I don't see young black women with cancer. I don't see it anywhere. So how do I know that I will survive? So being part of the campaigns makes me feel like I can be that person that I needed, and other young black women will see me and say, well, do you know what, she went through it and she's still here and she's strong and she's getting by. So now, fortunately, I am cancer free. There's no more signs of any cancer in my body. It's made me consider what more I can do to kind of help the wider community. So I guess I just feel I've got a more of a zest for life, and I just want to help people more than ever.
That was Lucy's story. And for more information on how to spot signs and symptoms of breast cancer, head to our website, itv.com/London. There was frustration for Chelsea fans last night after their draw against Brighton. And finally, we've always had plenty of big names appearing on the programme, and 2021 was no different. The year started with famous faces appearing on Zoom, where else? But we did start to see them in person too. Here's a roundup of the best bits from ITV News London, virtually and in person.
There's going to be a fair few surprises in this new Bond movie.
It's mixed emotions, but I just want to celebrate tonight.
I'm so excited for fans to see it, and I'm so excited not to hold in the secrets anymore.
Please.
It's a Western. It has an all-black cast, which is probably, you know, like, feels like it shouldn't be the first one in a long time, but it is.
Safe to say, horrendous. Best part of 2 years for everybody around the world. It's just amazing that we actually get to be in one room together and celebrate. And, you know, on top of obviously us guys getting back together, the fans are all again together in one room with us. The energy is just unbelievable.
Kristen, our viewers have just seen you in the trailer and you absolutely embodied Princess Diana.
Literally just show-stoppingly, iconically cool.
Someone asked me what my advice to my younger self would be. Get therapy. And I mean that in a kind of positive way, because I'm a great believer in therapy as being a positive act of self-love.
This might have been a bad decision.
Are you going to serve it like that? Taxi for JJ.
It's funny, I think MasterChef wanted me on as well. I was like, did you see me on Bake Off? Come on.
It's Gabrielle! Yeah!
First time I got to actually sing in the mask, and it was so hot, I was like, I want to go home, I want my mum.
Jo, can you take a look at this amazing outfit?
I mean, sure, just this old thing, you know?
It's got pictures of him on it.
Oh, you know, it's got pictures of everyone on it, you know? The Jamie News, you know?
Because I don't want to wear a mask in the theatre, but as I've been saying to everybody, one character in my theatre has been wearing a mask for 35 years.
S Club songs, they're just so iconic today, and everyone likes to reach for the stars, don't they?
I've got a funny bone, and if you write funny and you act, you know, that, I think it does cheer people up. Not that I'm always cheerful.
Desperate to get back out there, to be honest, and I've got six kids at home, so I'm really pleased to be back out on the road. Keep on, keep on, keep on. You'll never stop this
thing. I will never let you go. What's your favourite place to hang out in London?
Oh, this is such a hard question. Probably Portobello Road, just because like there's always like a really good atmosphere and food.
Love
and
that.
How much are you looking forward to getting back into the wig and gown?
Well, you seem to be assuming I haven't been wearing them at home.
Well, you know, anything goes during lockdown, doesn't
you know
it?
What? Friday night's around mine.
That was London's year in showbiz. Nothing glitzy about the weather, I'm afraid. Here's Philippa Drew now with the forecast.
Making the most of it, whatever the weather. Octopus Energy sponsors ITV London weekday weather.
Hello again. It certainly has been a fairly cloudy day out there once more, but a very mild one too, despite the blustery winds. And for the next few days, well, we hold on to quite a bit of cloud. Some further rain at times, but it will remain very, very mild indeed. Out there at the moment then, lots of cloud on the scene. We keep hold of that cloud cover overnight tonight. Again, still thick enough in places to give a little patchy light rain or drizzle, and very much on the mild side as well. Now, towards the end of the night, you'll notice some rain moving into the very far west there. That will swing its way quickly east tomorrow morning. I think by the time most of us get up, it should be clear. And actually, for the rest of the day, it looks relatively promising. Certainly lots of dry weather and hopefully a bit more brightness than we've had in recent days. Another mild one as well. Again, fairly blustery winds, but highs tomorrow 14 or 15 Celsius quite easily. Now, through the latter stages of New Year's Eve, that all-important countdown to 2022, it looks set to stay largely dry, albeit becoming rather cloudy. New Year's Day itself getting off to a pretty promising start, but rain out towards the west first thing. I think by the time it gets to us, little more than quite cloudy skies, but unsettled as we start the new year.
Octopus Energy sponsors ITV London weekday weather.
And that's how London's looking this evening. From all of us here on the London team, thank you very much for watching and have a great evening. Bye-bye.